আসসালামু আলাইকুম, শুভেচ্ছা নিন সুপ্রিয় দর্শক শ্রোতা, আপনাদের সবাইকে স্বাগত জানাচ্ছি উইথ শাইখ সিরাজ অনুষ্ঠানে। আমাদের আজকের এই অনুষ্ঠানের অতিথি বাংলাদেশে নিযুক্ত মার্কিন রাষ্ট্রদূত মার্শা বার্নিকাট। অনুষ্ঠানে যাওয়ার আগে তার সম্পর্কে আপনাদেরকে আমি একটু ধারণা দিয়ে রাখছি। তার কর্মজীবন, ছাত্রজীবন, কীভাবে তিনি বেড়ে উঠেছেন, সবগুলো বিষয় নিয়ে আজকে আলোচনা করব। বাংলাদেশে তিনি গত 4 ফেব্রুয়ারি 2015 তারিখে মার্কিন রাষ্ট্রদূত হিসেবে যোগ দিয়েছেন। এর আগে US ডিপার্টমেন্ট অফ স্টেটের জনসম্পদ ব্যুরোর ডেপুটি অ্যাসিস্ট্যান্ট সেক্রেটারি হিসেবে দায়িত্ব পালন করেছেন। 2008 থেকে 2011 সাল পর্যন্ত সেনেগাল এবং গিনি বিসাউর রাষ্ট্রদূত হিসেবে দায়িত্বরত ছিলেন। ডেপুটি চিফ অফ মিশন হিসেবে বারবাডোজ এবং মালাউইতে কাজ করেছেন এই রাষ্ট্রদূত। 1992 থেকে 1995 সাল পর্যন্ত ভারতের নয়াদিল্লিতে ডেপুটি পলিটিক্যাল কাউন্সিলর হিসেবে কাজ করেন তিনি। 1980 সালে জর্জ টাউন ইউনিভার্সিটি থেকে স্নাতকোত্তর ডিগ্রি অর্জন করেছেন ফরেন সার্ভিস বিষয়ে। ডিপার্টমেন্ট অফ স্টেটসের অসংখ্য সম্মানজনক পদকে ভূষিত হয়েছেন তার অসামান্য অবদানের জন্য। সম্মানিত সুধী, আজ তার কর্মময় জীবনের গল্প আমরা শুনব, কীভাবে তিনি বেড়ে উঠেছেন, কোথায় কোথায় কাজ করেছেন এবং বাংলাদেশ সম্পর্কে তার চিন্তাভাবনা, এ সময় বাংলাদেশকে তিনি যতটুকু চেনেছেন। অনারেবল অ্যাম্বাসেডর, ওয়েলকাম টু চ্যানেল স্টুডিও।
থ্যাংক ইউ,
এন্ড ইট ইজ আওয়ার অনার এন্ড প্রিভিলেজ টু টক টু ইউ।
And likewise.
So nice of you. Ambassador, let's start today's talk with a simple thing. We would kindly like to know about your personal life. I mean, where were you born and grew up and how you spent your childhood?
Yes. I was born and raised in New Jersey. I was born in a town called Red Bank and grew up near a military base. This is important because about a third of our class every year changed as their parents were transferred out of the base to somewhere else. So I grew up with all these classmates who had lived in Europe and in Japan and throughout the United States.
Now come to the main interview question. Bangladesh is a key strategic partner of the United States in South Asia. And the USA has a true development partner for a long, long time. How do you look at the bonds between our two countries, Ambassador?
I'm so proud that our history is so long and so collaborative and so productive. I like to characterize our relationship as a true partnership.
Right, right.
Because it isn't just in development where we've made some spectacular advances together, but everything from counterterrorism to countering violent extremism to supporting and improving democratic institutions, to, of course, lifting people out of poverty.
Right, exactly.
We share values. We trust and respect one another. We communicate regularly and honestly with one another.
Yeah.
And all of these things build on a strong partnership. I'm very proud of the fact that President Obama regularly refers to advances that were developed here, like the deep fertilizer implantation device.
Yes.
Several of the president's key initiatives are all based here. Feed the Future, which is not just about food security, but also about food nutrition.
Exactly.
How do we use food?
Exactly. Ambassador, Bangladesh has experienced significant change in clean and renewable energy for the last couple of decades. As far as we know, the US, along with other development partners, are helping Bangladesh to introduce solar projects around the country. Would you please let our viewers know the details about?
As our economies expand, as we modernize, there is a real hunger for power everywhere in the world. And Bangladesh, I learned and am really proud of the fact that it has the fastest growing number of households adopting solar energy.
Bangladesh can be the hub of growth, global growth.
Yes. Our work actually with Bangladesh and solar power began back in 2000, where we had a small project with Grameen Shakti, which has grown. 65,000 homes receive solar power under that. But it's not.
And as well as the biogas plant.
Yes.
Energy from the biogas.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. But solar, when you think of solar, also think of agricultural applications, such as the solar irrigation pumps. And our newest enterprise is a project where we're busy mapping Bangladesh for wind. Why? So that entrepreneurs who want to develop wind-based power know where they can go. And so we expect to have the map completed by 2017.
Yeah. So far we know The United States is supporting Bangladesh to develop new high-yield and tolerant crops varieties under your agriculture and food security scheme.
Bangladesh has gone from being a country years ago that experienced famine to having tripled its yield in recent years. And now you're a rice exporter.
It's a very, very big success story here.
Huge.
160 million people here. And we produce our own food, own rice.
Exactly. And enough to export. You know,
This year we start exporting. Yeah.
Exactly. Congratulations.
Yeah, thank you.
So, you know, a huge success story. Seed varieties, saline tolerant, flood tolerant, and drought tolerant.
Bangladesh has achieved tremendous success on women empowerment and gender equality. Child and maternal mortality has been reduced significantly. How do you see this progress?
Bangladesh has made progress at a rate unparalleled in human recorded history.
Unparalleled
in human recorded history.
Yes.
19th century Japan came the closest. And so, you know, that's an extraordinary achievement. And of course, being healthy, being alive, are key requirements. But the fact that the Prime Minister has led the progress in making sure that women, that young girls and boys have free education available to them. Another huge accomplishment. In fact, if you look at Bangladesh and you look at the phenomenal economic achievement, that's been largely the result of the RMG sector.
You are absolutely right.
Who are the workers in the RMG sector?
Exactly.
Women. Who increasingly take the role in the majority of the aspects, the different stages of agricultural the cycle? Women.
Exactly.
So
exactly.
You empower women here and you empower the country.
The government's issue. Do you see any progress made on worker safety and labor rights in Bangladesh garments industry since the Jin Fashion Factory fire in November 2012 and the Rana Plaza factory collapse in April 2013? Is there any possibility that we might regain the GSP facilities?
I have to tell you, I think there's been tremendous progress made.
Yeah.
Those accidents, especially Rana Plaza, are again unprecedented in modern industrial history.
Yeah.
We have producers, we have buyers, we have government, we have donors, all working together to help strengthen the industry. We want to see and want to help make sure that the remediations take place. When you ask about GSP, one of the issues that has worried our U.S. trade representative who controls the GSP process for years is worker rights. I think if there was anything more tragic than the building collapsing at Rana Plaza, it was the fact that workers knew the building was unsafe and they told their supervisors and they were forced back into the plant to work. They didn't have a voice. We want to make sure that workers are able to organize in whatever manner possible so that their voice can be heard, particularly when it comes to safety and other issues, and so that when they organize, they don't have to worry about a threat of being fired or worse, being physically abused. And that voice can then help make the factory more productive. When we can show that kind of progress across the board on worker safety as well, worker rights as well as worker safety, it'll be an easy job to convince the U.S. trade representative.
Now, media.
Yes.
How do you see the role of media in Bangladesh as a whole in contributing to the development of the country's governance, good governance? In addition, what do you think about the need of development-oriented news and current affairs program on TV?
Having a good, strong press and a vibrant press like you have here in Bangladesh is really key to making sure that the country can continue to progress. And I note, from print media all the way to social media, Bangladesh is breaking records. The U.S. Embassy Facebook page has the most fans of any embassy Facebook page in the world, U.S. Embassy Facebook page.
Yes, Ambassador, social media is very powerful nowadays. I have 1.2 million likers on my Facebook verified page.
I am a real admirer of Channel I because of the role that this station has played, especially in reaching farmers about what they do and how they can do it better. I think the media has a very important role to play, whether we're talking about women's empowerment or, exactly. you know, look at the
health
event.
Health issues,
nutrition.
Life in nature.
Exact. Climate, I think, will be an increasing public service announcements. Congratulations for your role
Thank
in
you
that.
Thank you very much.
You know, many Bangladeshi wants to visit the United States for study at an American university. Is it difficult for them to get visa? How do you advise them?
Bangladesh is about to become one of the top 25 countries in the entire world sending students to the United States. There are over 5,000 Bangladeshi studying in the U.S. right now. Applicants who showed up to our student visa days recently, the majority of them received visas. So how does this work? We have in our American Center here in Baridara and at the EMK Center in Daimundi and at our American Center in Chittagong, full official student counseling services called Education USA. You can get assistance to help find the university that's right for you, how to navigate the application process, even how to find financial aid if it's available. Overall, the United States wants visitors. We want people to come and do business in the United States, and we definitely want students from overseas. They enrich our student campus. They gain a lot, and then they come back having a real enhanced understanding of the United States.
Bangladesh is leading the way in technology. At the Global Entrepreneurship Summit in Kenya a few days back, President Barack Obama praised Bangladesh for the country's use of technology at the election, and also because the country uses technology in daily life.
Every day around the world, millions of people send and save money with M-Pesa. Bangladesh, citizens work to keep elections safe using crowdsourcing platform.
How do you look at the remarkable expansion?
Well, I would point to a couple of different things. For one, mobile banking here is becoming a daily occurrence, which cuts out so many difficulties and especially helps people in rural areas. So that's tremendous. Do you use YouTube?
Of course. I have my own YouTube with more than 2 million viewers.
YouTube was co-founded by a Bangladeshi American.
Yes.
And not a couple of days ago, a team of Princeton physicists led by a Bangladeshi American again discovered a non-particle, which I'm a history major, so I can't explain the details, but it will revolutionize communications.
Exactly.
And so I think technology seems to
and
be...
In Bangladesh, mobile users, at least 100 million people use mobile.
Exactly. And in fact, it's the use of that mobile that gives people access to the kinds of information your television channel puts out, information beyond Bangladesh's borders. Technology, I think, has become a daily part of so many Bangladeshi's life.
Mozena, Den W. Mozena, the former ambassador, is my good friend and the great friend of Bangladesh, who traveled the entire Bangladesh. We have traveled a lot together to see the farming development and the rural Bengal. May I expect that we could also go out together and I could show you the spirit of resilient farmers of Bangladesh who have made this country a hub of growth and prosperity.
Can I just say, Ambassador Mozena and I have been friends for over 20 years. Unlike Ambassador Mozena, I did not grow up on a farm, but my grandparents were farmers.
Yeah.
And so this is my mother's father's family were farmers. And so the agricultural spirit of this country and my own country are very near and dear to me. I would love to hit the road with you and to visit farmers and to learn from you about their progress. That growth has not just been in industry, which is what you might presume if you come from outside Bangladesh, but that your service sector and your agricultural sector have all kept pace with that industrial growth.
Correctly said. We can think out of the box.
And it shows that farmers are a key contributor to the economic success story that Bangladesh is becoming.
Honorable Ambassador, already you spent 5 months in Bangladesh. How is Bangladesh to you? And how much do you like what you do now?
From the day I arrived in Bangladesh, I felt as though I was being welcomed home. Ambassador Rosina told me that would be the case, as did every other of our predecessors. When you come to Bangladesh, you are captured by Bangladesh. I'm urging everyone to get out, to learn as much as they can about Bangladesh. There are 500,000 Bangladeshis all over the United States right now. There's a growing number of Americans who are here, and you know, thousands, hundreds of thousands of tourists, and you know, increasing number of students who have studied in both countries. These make for the real bonds between two countries.
So, Ambassador, thank you very much. It is my pleasure talking to you. We heard a lot of things from you, your childhood, your study. So hope we will meet again in some other program. Thank you very much.
I look forward to it. Thank you.
May I now request Indureja Sagar, Managing Director, and Press Telephone Channel I, to come on stage and hand over the souvenir, the crest of Channel I.